guys, welcome back to another video of my channel. I am Vagisha Mishra. I review and decode beauty pageants at my channel. So if you're watching me for the first time and you don't want to miss out on any pageant updates, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button and also turn on the bell icon so you will be the first to get notified whenever a video goes live at my channel. So in this very video, I'm going to talk about the most commonly asked question in the pageant interview. Tell us about yourself. So basically, whenever you go for any pageant audition or even when you go for a closed door interview, this is the very common question which is encountered, and this becomes a little bit tricky one because although you have to talk about yourself, you should know how you should be answering to this tricky question, and will the interviewer be impressed with your answer or not? What kind of answer actually grabs the attention? That is all what we're going to discuss in today's video. So without further delay, let's get started. So basically, whenever somebody asks you to tell us about yourself, the interviewer is not really interested to know about you. The interviewer is more interested to know what are your objectives and what are your goals and what are those things which are really important to you, what really matters to you. So whenever you start talking about yourself, which is not very relevant to the pageant experience, and it does not give a bigger picture about your personality, it does not really give a huge impact in interviewer's mind. So the goal is to make the other people feel that you are here with a purpose, you are here with a goal, and you have a larger picture painted in your mind before you stepped out for your pageant audition. Basically, whenever the interviewer is asking to tell us about yourself, he wants to know whether you're fit for the title or not. Few of these points I have already covered in my previous video, so you can go ahead and watch that video if you haven't already. I have recently started a series on decoding pageant communication skills. So in that playlist, you can go to my channel and watch all the videos which are very much essential to prepare you for your pageant communication, your closed door interview and your on stage interviews questions. Now coming back to crack the very difficult question, tell me about yourself. So other than the facts which I have mentioned just now, you also need to convey your feelings and your emotion that why do you think that you're fit for that pageant title. So you have to start talking about your experiences, why you resonate with the pageant, and why exactly you're standing here to audition for the pageant. So you have to have a proper goal set in your mind. What is your vision? What is your long-term preparation for the pageant journey, and how you're actually going to utilize that title if given a chance at all? Apart from that, you also have to convince the interviewer that you fit the international pageant criteria. Now there are many other international pageant criteria, like for Miss World, beauty with a purpose is a must. For Miss Universe, you definitely need to have an advocacy, but you need to show your fierce aura more. So now IMG has taken over Miss Universe organization, and we need spokesperson like Zuzi Mini Tunzi, Catriona Gray and Pia Wurzbach. So you have to show those elements in your speech whenever you are talking about yourself. So although your answer is focused on you and your qualifications, your experiences and your vision and goals, but you definitely need to show certain elements which can tell the interviewer that yes, you are fit for a pageant like Miss World, or you're fit for a pageant like Miss Grand International, Miss Supranational or Miss Universe. So you basically have to affirm that yes, I am suitable for this particular international pageant. You don't have to say it in words, but you have to show with your words and your wisdom, your grace and your aura that which is that pageant that you resonate very well with. The number two element which you need to have whenever you're talking about yourself is to tell them who you actually are. When you're talking about your real personality, you have to maintain a proper balance. You have to talk about your personal experiences and also professional experience. Don't go overboard with your modeling experiences. It's good to tell about a few modeling projects, but you don't have to be very specific when you're talking about your modeling experiences. And also, if you are a former pageant queen or if you have participated in any other pageant, you don't need to specify those details again and again. When you continuously talk about those pageants where you have participated initially, people actually tend to take you as somebody who is very arrogant and overconfident, and you are actually boastful about your qualifications or your achievements, which is what we don't really want to do. So you can start with, hi, I am so and so. You can talk about your name, and then you can talk about your keen interest. What made you to participate in this pageant? What are your long-term visions? And what are your goals for the pageant if given a chance to represent India internationally? Don't say it in words, but try to give them justifications. Try to show them your actions. If you have done enough actions in your past, and if you have actually performed something significant in your past, be it your professional experience or be it your pageant experience, then you can definitely list that out. The third thing to keep in mind is to avoid superlatives. Now, although I have said that you have to talk about accomplishments, but that does not really mean that you have to use superlatives like I am the best in so and so, I am the best person in so and so. You have to show the interviewer that you're rooted, you're humble, you're very down to earth, you're very graceful. You don't want to come across as somebody who is very arrogant about her achievements. I think we all respect Tejaswini Manokna from the bottom of our hearts, but the kind of introduction she put up in the auditions as well as in the introduction, that was something which was a turn off for many pageant critics and pageant fans. So despite of holding so many achievements, when she talked about many things like she was praised and appreciated by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, that was not directly related to her achievements. That is not something which you can put up as an achievement. So you have to be very careful and alert what kind of words you are choosing to describe about yourself. And if you are humble enough, and if you are very much modest about the selection of the words you are making, then people will not miss the chance to take you in the pageant and give you an opportunity to show your real persona even more brightly. The next thing you have to show them is to show why you are actually fit for the title. Tell them the reason why you're applying for this pageant. It should not be something which is very silly, like a childhood dream or something which is very common. Talk about the real purpose you have in your mind. Don't be blunt with your answers. Be very objective, be very smart, and be very modest. This is the time and opportunity where you can actually show them why you are keenly interested in this particular pageant. Now, this question is usually linked up with another question. Why Miss World? Why Miss Universe? So you need to have a proper answer framed up in your mind. Do not sound desperate at all. The reason why many girls fail to make it to the final audition applying year after year is the fact that they try to show the desperation. I have been a part of this pageant, I have been a part of that pageant, and then they try to list out all the pageants where they have participated. Now, this kind of attitude and approach does not really get a positive feedback, and you tend to miss out on creating a very humble and real persona about yourself. So this is the reason why you should not be talking about yourself as an overachiever. You should be humble enough to project the things which you have in your mind, but still you should limit the achievements and the qualification, which does not really matter in the long run. So limit your boundaries, don't step outside the boundaries. Now you have to understand that you have maximum 90 seconds to make your impression. Usually when we talk about the research, most of the impressions are made within 15 to 20 seconds, and the first impression is made in the 7 seconds itself. So it's up to you how you carry forward that impression and how maximum utilization you can make with your words and your ideas and your personality when you're talking about yourself. So use those 90 seconds very wisely. Don't go overboard. Be very precise and concise, and be very coherent and logical whenever you're talking. Now, although I have said time and again that you should always talk about your life story, but don't be very vague with your life story. You are not somebody who's a celebrity right now. So nobody is actually eager or very keen to listen about your life journey in very specific details. So be very generic with your life story and don't go overboard telling the few detailed examples of your life where people actually are not interested to know what is happening with you in your personal life. People just want to know how you maintain your composure when you're facing any challenges in your life. So that is what you have to reflect. The last thing and the key thing which we have to keep in mind whenever we are talking about the question, tell us about yourself, is to be very much confident. Maintain the proper eye contact. If the panel of the jury has about 4 to 5 members, then maintain eye contact with all the people sitting there in the jury. Don't look at the ceiling, don't look here and there. Just maintain the eye contact very precisely. Also, one thing which you have to keep in mind is to avoid talking like a robot. You have to stop talking in an artificial tone. A good conversation is never a monologue, but always a conversation. So whenever you're answering your pageant answer, make it sound like a conversation and not a dramatic monologue. So don't be a Shakespeare while answering your pageant question. Don't be very dramatic with your tone and your pitch, about which I have already talked about in voice modulation. So if you haven't watched that already, go ahead and watch that video. The link is placed somewhere here. The last tip which I would like to give is to always show excitement and energy whenever you're speaking. Your energy and your enthusiasm should reflect in your voice. You should be very excited when you're talking. So show that in your voice, and the entire persona you build around yourself is based on this very excitement. So show that with your smile, with your eyes, with your facial expressions. Be very lively and animated, and I am sure that jury will love you. So that was all for today's video. Do let me know in the comment section if you found this video helpful. Also, let me know the video ideas which you would like to see at my channel. Drop down them in the comment section. And I will see you guys soon with the next one. If you haven't followed me already on social media, you can go ahead and follow me at Pageants with Vagisha. Until next time.